to tonight's game. We've got the Portageville Bulldogs hosting the Scott City Rams in this high school football matchup here tonight from Vic Reeves Athletic Field in Portageville. We're in week six of high school football action here in Missouri as these two teams come in. Getting ready for the coin toss out of midfield. Portageville coming in with a record of 2-3 on the year. And the Scott City Rams an undefeated 5-0 impressive record coming in here tonight. Some notable wins for these teams. Portageville probably putting up a school record last week. Don't know that officially, but it's got to be close. An 89-0 victory over the Kelly Hawks. And the Scott City Rams, their most notable win probably over the East Prairie Eagles. Had a 4-point victory over them, I think, in week three, somewhere around there. But nonetheless, a nice victory for the Scott City Rams coming in at undefeated, looking to go 6-0 after the game tonight. And Portageville looking to get a win on their home field homecoming festivities here tonight. So going to be a pump Portageville team to try to get a victory. Somewhat of an upset victory here tonight over Scott City. And we're over halfway mark now of the regular season. Got 9 regular season games in Missouri and then a first round district tournament game. Everyone will have a 10th game on the year. So we're over the halfway mark. It's hard to imagine that we haven't even got out of 90 degree weather and the season's already half over. So that's just the way it's been this year, but ready to go. We've got a great night here. It is warm, but not near as muggy as it has been. And we've got, lighting up the sky. I wouldn't say lighting up the sky, but in the sky we've got a nice smoke coming from Shirley, a burnt cornfield, which it's harvest time here in late September. And the Scott City Rams will receive the opening kickoff. And Portageville will kick off. Pretty nice crowd out here tonight for homecoming here in week six of high school football. We're glad to bring it to you right here on YHC TV and online at YHCTV.com. And hopefully you'll join us the rest of the way for this high school football season. Go Nicholas Allred going to be kicking off for the Bulldogs, the senior. Get this game started. And here we go. Kick deep down the near side. And set for a turn here towards midfield and gets out close to the 30-yard line. Bringing up first and 10 for the Rams. First and 10, heavy formation for the Rams. Handoff along the right side. And a gain of 3 or 4, it looks like. Braden Cox with the carry. Ryan Priggle on the stop, brings up a second and six, gain of four on the play. Second down. And quick handoff along the right side. He breaks through, and he's got the open field. He's going to be chased down from behind. Hunter Yates right there with the tackle inside the 10-yard line, but a big gain for Braden Cox, taking it inside, right inside the 10-yard line, right at the 10-yard line. Big gain for the Scott City Rams. And Hunter Yates saving the touchdown, chasing him down from behind. Good effort on his part to save the six. But the Rams are knocking on the end zone of the Bulldogs here. Let's see what happens here. It's going to be first and goal from the 9-yard line. Heavy formation. One wide receiver to the left. And a handoff to Cox, and he's going to get maybe a couple yards and covered up. And actually no gain on the play, so to bring up second and goal from the 9-yard line, just inside 11 minutes to play here in the first quarter. Nice drive here by the Rams. Let's see if they can punch it in here. Three back formation, one wide receiver, and a quick handoff up the middle. And maybe just a few yards at the most, not much there. R.J. Nelson in on the stop for the Bulldogs. The third and goal from the 8, a gain of 1 on that one. Third and 8 coming up. Surely we're in 4 down territory here. Ty Wilthon, the quarterback, takes the snap, hands it off, and a carry inside the 5-yard line. Going to be just short of the goal line. Braden Cox with the carry, and that'll bring up fourth and goal here, just a few yards out from the end zone. Fourth and goal from the 5 for the Rams here. Big chance to come up with a big stop here for the Bulldogs. Got a chance to force a turnover on downs after they gave up the big run by Braden Cox inside the 5-yard line here. Let's see if the Bulldogs come up with a stop. Wilfong under center. Takes a snap, hands off to Cox, and he's close to the end zone, and he is in. We've got a signal from the side judge of touchdown for the Scott City Rams, getting the Rams on the board first. With a touchdown run by Braden Cox. Tough carry there. He just got across the plane, putting the Rams on the board 6-0. And extra point attempt coming. A little snap, gets it down. The kick's up, looks good, and it is. Nice conversion there on the extra point off the low snap. So it'll make it 7-0 in favor of the Scott City Rams here with 9 minutes remaining here in the first quarter. Scott City with a quick strike. And we want to recognize some of our sponsors. A-plus Family Clinic here in Portageville along 203 East 3rd Street. Family nurse practitioner Lorna Turnage and staff wish best of luck to the Bulldogs this year, and they're available for all of your medical solutions. Call for your next appointment, 573-379-2100. A-plus Family Clinic along East 3rd Street in Portageville. Appreciate the fine folks there at A-plus Family Clinic helping bring you high school football right here on YHC TV Channel 21 on your New Wave cable. Thank you to A-plus Family Clinic in Portageville. And about set for the kickoff here. Looks like number 34, that's Jimmy May, freshman for Scott City Rams, going to do the kickoff duties for the Rams here. See if Portageville come up with a nice return here. They've got Ian Torrey and Hunter Gates back deep to return. I'll tell you, it's Jimmy May. He's a small fella, 5'2", but he may have the foot here. Is this going to be an onside kick? Kick short, picked up by the Bulldogs. Very aggressive onside kick by the Rams, but recovered. By the Bulldogs, so it'll be first and 10 Bulldogs here at midfield at the 44-yard line. Nice field position here for Portageville. With a chance to take advantage of the aggressiveness by the Rams here. Ian Torrey lined up under center. And mishandled snap, and he falls on it. And bring up second and down for a loss of 2 yards on the play. So rough start here for the Bulldogs. Going to bring up second and 12 coming up. And spread formation for the Bulldogs, as we've seen all year. Torrey takes the snap, drops back, goes left, and almost completed, just out of the reach. And Connor Barham, the intended receiver, sophomore receiver for the Bulldogs, third and 12 here for Portageville. See if they can get some yardage here. Here we go, snap. Torrey looking deep down the right side, looking for Priggle, but knocked away. Nice pass defended by number 20, Jaden Kaiser. And Ryan Priggle, the intended receiver, down the seam. Good defense there by Kaiser, stepping over to defend that pass. Bring up fourth and long, fourth and 12, 8.5 minutes remaining here in the first quarter. Ian Torrey back to punt. And it looks like Braden Cox back to receive the punt. And Torrey gets it off. It's an end-over-end punt down the middle of the field. It'll take not much of a bounce there. And down inside the 30-yard line, about the 29, looks like. So a pretty decent punt there by Torrey, pushing the Rams back. So it'll be first and 10 at around the 30-yard line for the Rams. So the Rams got off to a quick start, scored in 3 minutes. Here opening the game. So we'll see what they can do on their second series here. Braden Cox, one of the top backs in Southeast Missouri. He's had a great year so far. And off to a great start here tonight. Strong, heavy formation here, as we've seen all night. Three backs in the backfield, one wide receiver to the near side. And a sweep out left, and it's Cox with the carry, and he's going to be brought down for a gain of about two. And Dakota Ivy with the tackle for the Bulldogs. 8 minutes to go here in the first quarter. And here we go, second and 8. And a handoff to Cox in the backfield. He's got a pretty good carry here out past the 35-yard line. Well, Cox getting a lot of action here early on. Ryan Priggle on the stop for the Bulldogs. He'll bring up a third and a long four, looks like. For the Rams, big down here for the Bulldogs. Able to get the ball back with some decent field position. They can come up with a stop here. Wilthong with the snap, hands it off up the middle, and stuffed for about a yard, maybe two. Nice defense by the Bulldogs. And Chris Garman in on the tackle among a host of Bulldogs. A nice job swarming towards Cox to stop his momentum, as it's going to bring up a fourth and four. So they may have gained half a yard on that one. So still stay at four, fourth and four, 6.5 minutes remaining. See what the Rams elect to do. Looks like they're going to line up and go for it here, unless it's going to be a little pooch kick. But looks like we're going for it. Fourth and four. Here we go. And a handoff to Cox, and he's going to be covered up by a host of Bulldogs, and big stop for Portageville, forcing the turnover on downs in Scott City territory. Big stop, and could be a momentum shifter here early on, as Portageville in great field position. Going to have first and 10 at about the 37-yard line. And we got a timeout on the field, so we're going to take a quick break, and we'll be right back.
We at First National Bank proudly announce our new name, FM Bank, First Missouri Bank of SEMO.
When most banks change their name, new ownership is usually the case. This is not true with First National Bank. We have made the positive decision to streamline and update not only our name, but also our look. We have a fresh new logo, signage, lobby graphics, brochures, the works. With the same great service and friendly faces that you have come to expect and deserve, First National Bank is now FM Bank, First Missouri Bank of SEMO.
The area's fastest internet just got faster. Introducing 100 Meg Internet, now available from New Wave. With 100 Meg, there's nothing you can't do. Browse better, stream more, power every device. This is lightning-fast internet designed to fit your family's needs. It's brand new, and it's the fastest game in town. Get 100 Meg Internet from New Wave, your local provider of the speed you need. Call 1-888-8-NEW-WAVE today.
And we're back here at Vic Reeves Athletic Field. The Portageville Bulldogs just come off a big stop on fourth down. And getting possession of the ball here at the Scott City 37-yard line, first and 10. Ian Torrey takes the shotgun snap. He rolls out right, looks downfield. He's got a man down the center of the field, but it's picked off. Underthrown just a bit and picked off at around the 10-yard line. And Braden Cox making a big name for himself already in this game. Offensively, now defensively, picking off the pass. Ian Torrey had, looked like it was Ryan Priggle down the middle of the field, but he was rolling out right. Priggle was running more up the middle of the field, and he was open deep, but he had to get more on it to be able to hit him in stride, come up just a bit short. So it'll be first and 10 Rams at the 18-yard line. And Wilthong under center. Hands it off the right side. And nice, decent gain there. Looks like Cox on the carry. And Cox has been the workhorse here for the Rams early on. He gets a gain of about 4 yards. Brings up second and six. Now inside of 6 minutes remaining here in the first quarter. Make it second and seven. And a handoff, and a gain of about 3 yards on the play, it looks like, on the right side. Braden Cox on the carry again. That'll bring up a third and a long two. 5 minutes remaining here in the first quarter. Go Another handoff to Cox, and he's met at the line of scrimmage. Looks like no gain on the play. Looks like we'll bring up a fourth down. Coming up, we'll see if Scott City keeps up the aggression here as they went on a couple fourth downs here. Looks like no gain on the play. Fourth and two coming up. And they will be going for it. And a handoff to the up back, the fullback up the middle, and it's going to be close. It's hard to tell from this angle, but it looks like he may have gotten at least a yard. I don't know if he got the second yard or not. And it will be short again. Big stop by the Bulldogs, forcing the turnover on downs. That's two straight Scott City offensive possessions, ending in a turnover on downs, unable to convert the fourth down. So Portageville got some good field position here. Once again, 28-yard line this time. I think they're on the 37 on the previous one. Now they're up to the 28. So we'll see if they can fare better on this possession. Ian Torrey in the shotgun, takes the shotgun snap, and he's going to have a keeper along the right side. He's got space, goes to the outside. He couldn't get the pile on, and he's close, and he's in for the touchdown. Big run. Ian Torrey getting the Bulldogs on the board. Oh, a nice design play there. 28 yards out. Torrey faked it. Faked the handoff up the middle off the right side. Bounced it out to the sideline and beat the Scott City defenders to the pylon, getting the Bulldogs on the board. Big play for this Portageville offense. We're just under 4 minutes to play in this first quarter. And Portageville's got a chance to tie the game here with this extra point attempt. And the snap is down, the hold, and it's a line drive, no good. So the score will remain at 7-6 in favor of the Scott City Rams. And we want to recognize some more of our sponsors, Greenpoint Ag in Portageville. Keep them in mind for your next crop coming up this spring, offering seed, fertilizer, crop production products, and custom application services. Multiple locations here in Southeast Missouri, as you see there. Portageville, Kennett, Sykeston, Crothersville, Baldwin, Katrin, and Glenville. Go online to greenpointag.com for more information or give them a call here in Portageville, 379-3816. That's Greenpoint Ag in Portageville. Appreciate them helping bring you high school football right here on Channel 21, YHC-TV and YHCTV.com. And homecoming night, throwing out some souvenirs, looks like, down below us here. The cheerleaders getting the fans riled up, so a good time here in Portageville tonight. Vic Reeves Athletic Field. Just under 4 minutes remaining here in the first quarter. And the kickoff up and deep down the middle. And Cox looks like he took a knee as he caught that ball, so it's going to be a nice kick. Going to be down inside the 15-yard line. Looks around the 10-yard line from here. So that's one thing about high school and college. You put that knee down with possession of the ball, you're automatically down, and that will be the case at the 10-yard line, first and 10. Can't ask for better field position if you're the Portageville Bulldogs. So a nice start here. Let's see if the Rams can get a little momentum. They had a great first drive, drove the ball up the field, punched it in on a fourth down and goal possession. And in the last two possessions, Portageville's come up strong, getting some turnover on downs. We'll see what they can do on this drive. Wilfong under center, takes a snap, hands it off. Looks like to Cox on the outside. He's got some room, brought down for about a 3 yard gain, looks like. Braden Cox has taken about every offensive handoff, every run handoff tonight, I think, other than maybe two carries. So he's the workhorse for the Rams. Already has an interception as well on defense. So we're seeing a heavy dose of Braden Cox here early on. Going to be second and six coming up. A gain of four on the play. And a handoff. Gain of a couple. Braden Cox on the carry. And Brian Pearson in on that tackle for the Bulldogs. Pearson's been a big-time defender for the Bulldogs this year. Linebacker in on a whole lot of tackles halfway through this season. Under 3 minutes remaining, we've got a third and five after a, actually it's a third and four after a gain of two on the play. And pretty good defense here by the Bulldogs these last couple possessions. And a play action pass and thrown downfield, incomplete. And couldn't quite see who it was intended for. But that'll bring up fourth down. And Scott City will punt. Sure, yeah, no surprise here at the 15-yard line. Going to punt away to the Bulldogs. Ian Torrey and Hunter Gates back deep to return this punt. Great opportunity here for the Bulldogs. Got two playmakers here receiving this punt. And it's going to go along the far side. Ian Torrey going to pick it up. And he's going to run to the near side. He's got a great block out front. And he's got out past midfield around the 45-yard line. And what a block. Didn't quite see who got that block, but really laid the wood on the Scott City Ram here in the backfield. He got blindsided, but he's up and ready to go here on defense. Good to see there. First and 10 for the Bulldogs at the 45-yard line. Great field position for these Bulldogs. Had a great one play drive here. Just on the last offensive series, Ian Torrey took it to the house from about 28 yards out. And here we go, shotgun snap. Torrey's looking along the near sideline, a little high for Gates. Bringing up second and 10, Gates on a pretty nice hook route here on the near side, but just a little high. Quick handoff up the middle, hit that hole hard, got a gain of about 4 yards on the play. Lamar Alexander getting his first carry of the night. Gets out to the 40-yard line, a gain of five, bringing up a third and five, just under 2 minutes remaining here in the first quarter. And shotgun snap, a keeper. Torrey looking on the left side, getting some nice blocking out front, cuts it up, and he's going to cross the first down marker. Nice run for Torrey with the keeper. Dodged some tackles, gets out past the 35-yard line, it looks like. Actually, they're going to be at around the 31-yard line. Nice gain there by Portageville. First and 10, minute and a half remaining here in the first. Torrey with the snap, he's rolling out right, and he's got some space, and he's gonna keep it, and gets along the sideline, and out of bounds. Looks like he's got a gain of about 4 to 5 yards on the near sideline. Actually, he got about 8 yards. Hard to tell running here on the near sideline. The sticks are on the opposite side, so it's going to be a second down and one, a gain of nine on the play. Come on, And another keeper. Torrey's going to bounce it out to the right. He's got the first down looking for more, and he's pushed out of bounds. Inside looks like the 15-yard line. Easy first down run for Torrey. That's been the big part of their offense here early on. Torrey just taking these keepers, running off these tackles on the left and right side, finding space. Been successful so far. First and 10, Bulldogs from the 9-yard line. It's going to be first and goal. Now inside the 10-yard line. Here we go. Got a keeper along the left side, and he's caught behind the line, and he breaks the tackle. He's swinging it back this way, and he's got a man in the end zone wide open, and is it caught? And it's not caught. It's incomplete. Wow. Injury timeout as we got a Scott City Ram down. And we'll just keep it right here. What a play that developed there. It was a design, it looked like a design run play to the left that really got into trouble, and Torrey was able to break out of it and run here to the near sideline, rolled out, and I didn't quite see who was in the end zone, but he snuck down the field towards the back of the end zone and looked for him, and he just come up short on the catch, so it'll bring up a second and 10. It's actually outside of the 10-yard line at the 12-yard line. We mentioned it was first and goal from the 9, but it's actually at the 12, second and 10. But good elusiveness there by Torrey. Be able to look down the field, had a guy open, but just couldn't quite execute it. So we'll bring up a second and 10 here. And we got a minute to play in this first quarter, and can't quite see who that is walking off the field, but looks like he's going to be able to go off on his own power. Looks like it may be Dakota Talley, Jr. for the Rams. And here we go, second down. Torrey's dropping back, looking downfield. He's going to get pushed out of the pocket, going left. He's got some space, but he's going to look to throw at the end zone. And it looks like it's caught for the touchdown. What a grab along the sideline. And Hunter Gates on the reception. And we got a penalty on the play.
Holding against the Bulldogs.
And it's going to be holding, so it'll come back.
No good.
And it could be a backbreaker. You take away a touchdown, especially holding. It's a 10-yard penalty and likely in the backfield. So it's going to be a pretty big penalty here for the Bulldogs. They're on the doorstep of the end zone here. Going to be pushed back towards the 24-yard line, something like that. They were on the 12. Getting pushed back inside the 25, it looks like. At the 22-yard line, 48 seconds to go. Still second down, and drop off on the middle and incomplete. Ryan Priggle, the intended receiver, couldn't quite haul it in. Brings up third and 20. here for the Bulldogs. So don't have to make it all up at once. This is four down territory here, deep in Scott City territory, so they can try to pull off a 10 to 12 yard gain if the deep ball isn't there, or the deep play. Make themselves a manageable fourth down here. Torrey backing up, and he's going to try to dump it off for a screen, and he does, and he's got some space. And pretty nice gain. Lamar Alexander takes the screen, takes along the far side. Looks like he's going to bring up a fourth and maybe 6 or 7 yards. Looks like fourth and seven. Fourth and six coming up with 29 seconds remaining here in the first quarter. So a nice play there. Gets them in position. A manageable fourth down so they didn't have to go here from like fourth and 20. So a manageable fourth down here for the Bulldogs. Rolling out. Torrey looking. And he's going to be inside the five. Close to a touchdown. And it is a touchdown. Ryan Priggle with the touchdown, giving the Bulldogs the lead, 12-7. I knew they were close down there inside the five, but couldn't quite tell if he was at the pylon, and he certainly was. A nice pass from Torrey, hitting Priggle, crossing the goal line, making it a 12-7 lead for the Bulldogs. And they're going for two to try to make up for that lost attempt. And it is good. Ian Torrey stretches out over the goal line, making it a 14-7 score in favor of the Bulldogs. And a great drive by the Bulldogs. Backed up, third and 20. They got about a 14-yard gain to bring up a fourth and six, and they converted with a touchdown pass to Ryan Priggle. And on now with the lead, the Portageville Bulldogs with 20 seconds remaining here in the first quarter. And we want to recognize Delta Auto Parts and Salvage here in Portageville along Highway 61 north here in Portageville, specializing in domestic car and light truck parts. Colin Darty and his staff can get you set up with any auto parts you need and salvage. Go to deltaautoparts.com for any parts information. We appreciate Delta Auto Parts and Salvage helping bring you high school football right here on YHC TV. And here we go. Kickoff coming up. High kick along the sideline, going to be threat out of bounds, but takes a bounce inside. And looks like that's Braden Cox picking it up. He's going to get out past the 20, out past the 25. Stopped at the 27-yard line. We got 14 seconds remaining here in the first quarter. And here we go, first and 10 from the 27-yard line for the Rams. Wilthong out of the shotgun this time. It's not Wilthong. It may have been Cox on the carry. Yep, Braden Cox on the carry out of the shotgun. That will bring it in to the first quarter as we've got a 14-7 lead in favor of the Portageville Bulldogs. It's been an entertaining first half, and we're going to take a break and be back with the second half, or second quarter, coming up.
Clear. There's a better way to jumpstart your soil back to health. Apply Enzone to protect and increase nitrogen efficiency without killing bacteria. Apply Prevent to increase phosphorus availability and reduce fixation. Better yet, use them both to get more from your fertilizer investment and see higher potential yields. Ag Explorer, your prescription for healthy soil.
Hi, I'm Shane Horner.
Hi, I'm Tim Ellison.
Hi, my name is Richard Clark.
I'm Lori Amos.
I'm Rob Blackwell.
And I'm Ryan Bassetti.
Hi, I'm Alan King.
Hello, I'm Larry Ellison, and we're proud to be part of the Harry Blackwell Ford family here in Malden, Missouri.
And we're back at Vic Reeves Athletic Field in Portageville. Portageville coming off a nice touchdown drive off of, once again, a fourth down stand from the defense, getting a short field situation. Now we're getting set for the second quarter. And the Scott City Rams got the ball at the 31-yard line. And here we go, second and six from the 31. Wilfong hands it off. Cox with the carry, and he's got space. He breaks out past the 45-yard line for about a 14-yard gain on the play. And a big carry for Cox and the Rams. And handoff to Cox, gets about 2 to 3 yards on the play. Looks like a gain of three. Carlos Johnson in the stop for the Bulldogs to bring up a second and seven. Wilthong under center, heavy formation. Cox with the carry once again. Going to be a gain of about 2 yards. Going to bring up third and five coming up. And Portageville's defense come up big here in the last two possessions, forcing two turnover on downs. So here's a big third down coming up. Crowds into it. And play action pass going deep down the middle of the field and picked off. Big interception down the middle of the field. Lamar Alexander picking it off. And well covered by the Bulldogs. Not only Alexander, but they had three Bulldogs in the vicinity on that pass. And coming up with the interception is Alexander. First to 10 for these Bulldogs. Oh, great play by Alexander. I mean, he could have easily knocked it down, but he rose up, went to the highest point to where only he was going to get it, and brought it down, forcing the turnover. Now a deep pass. Ian Torrey looking down the sideline. He's open and almost brought down. It may have been just wide down the sideline. Looking for Hunter Gates. Deep pass, which Torrey's got that ability. A couple weeks ago against the Mohawks when we had Portageville and Piggott down and Piggott, Torrey had a couple passes deep that was well executed. So he certainly has that capability, and Hunter Gates has got the open speed as well. Once he gets down that sideline, he can get behind any defense. Here we go, second down and 10. And a quick handoff. Alexander hits the hole hard. He's out past the 35-yard line for an easy first down, approaching right at the 40. And he hit that hole hard. And first and 10 at around the 40-yard line, right at the 40-yard line. And a snap, and Alexander's going to get the carry. And he gets a couple yards on the carry. Pretty good defense up there up front by the Rams. Looks like that was number 75, Matt Shepper. And on the tackle, the sophomore defensive tackle. Nine and a half minutes remaining here in the first half. And Torrey's going to keep it along the left side. He's got some good yardage. Gets around the 48-yard line and get pushed out. He'll be just short of the first down. Be about 2 yards short, maybe a yard short. Yeah, he got about a yard and a half. So it'll be fourth and two coming up for these Bulldogs. Third down. Third down and two. And a jump up front. Looks like it may be on the defense. And that is the case. That'll be a first down and a 5-yard penalty. At the 46-yard line for the Bulldogs into Scott City territory now. Torrey with the shotgun snap and mishandles it. And he's looking downfield. He's got an open receiver to Pringle. He's opened up the sideline and crossed the 30-yard line. And a nice gain for the Bulldogs. Looks like it may have been in trouble, but Torrey picked it up. Looks wide open. Looks for a wide open Ryan Pringle. And a big gain. First and 10 from the 28-yard line. And hand off to Alexander. He's quick up the hole. He can go all the way, and he is. Takes it all the way in the end zone. 28-yard run for Lamar Alexander. What a great run. Great blocking up front. I don't even think he was even touched. All the way into the end zone. Great run by Lamar Alexander. Makes the score 20-7 in favor of these Bulldogs. Boy, Alexander's hitting the hole hard. I think it looks that good because the interior linemen are getting a great push, great separation, where he can just hit that hole, that A-gap, right up the middle. And he's been hitting it hard. And a big part of that's that offensive line up front for the Bulldogs. Here, going for two. Torrey's going to keep it up the middle, bounces out to the left, and he's going to come up just a bit short. No, runs out of room along the sideline, so the score remains at 20-7 with under just 9 minutes remaining here in the first half. These Bulldogs are coming up with a great effort here in this first half. Defense translating to offense, and off to a good start here in the first half. And we'll take a look at some more of our sponsors. Butler Drugstore in Portageville at 222 East Main Street. And they've been a longtime supporter of us here at YHC for these broadcasts, and we appreciate that. That's Dr. Trey Roan and his staff at Butler Drugstore on Main Street in Portageville. Give them a call. 573-379-5469, and it's a full-service pharmacy. Also a nice selection of gifts and jewelry there at Butler Drugstore. Appreciate them helping bring you high school football right here on YHC TV. And that's ready for kickoff here. And after the kick, going to be out to about the 35-yard line, first and 10 for the Rams. Go. We'll see if Scott City can put something together. They've struggled ever since that first offensive possession. And nice defense here by the Bulldogs, stuffing the line of scrimmage. Travis Johnson in on the stop for the Bulldogs. And a gain of one on the play to bring up a second and 9. And drop back pass, a hook route on the near side here. Nice reception, and he's down right at the first down marker. Looks like he may just be a bit short. It's going to be close. And Caden Hilleman on the reception. Senior Ram, and I'm looking right down, perfect angle here. It looks like it's just a bit short. I'm looking right down the first down marker. They're going to give it to him. Wow. Can't believe that. I'm looking perfectly right down the first down marker, and it's just a bit short. So I guess they were pretty generous on that spot. First and 10. Hand off to Braden Cox, and he's going to get stuffed at the line of scrimmage. Maybe a gain of one. Yeah, it looks like he got a yard on it, so to bring up a second 9 with 7 minutes remaining here in the first half. And Wilthong under center, you're going to sweep it out to Cox, and he's going to get maybe to the line of scrimmage, but nowhere really to run as the Bulldogs are swarming. These linebackers are really getting to these sidelines and not allowing Brayton Cox to break out for that big run. So it'll actually be a short loss on the play, still bring up 3rd and 9. Good defense by these Bulldogs. Braden Cox, big, tough running back, and they've got after him ever since that first offensive possession. Not really allowed him to break open. Here we go, 3rd and a long 9. It's going to be pass play. He's going to try to dump it off, and it's going to be incomplete. Looking for the screenplay. So bring up 4th down. We'll see if Scott City will elect to go for it. Looks like we got some personnel coming out. So it looks like we'll probably look at a punting play here on 4th and long. Yeah. and they will be punting. 6 minutes to go here in the second quarter. Got Torrey and Gates back deep to receive the punt, and it's going to be a short one, probably not returned here. Well, it was a good bounce, and Gates just lets it come to a roll, so that'll bring up first and 10. Pretty good punt there by Scott City with the roll. So Portageville going to have to march a good ways here for a score. And we got a timeout on the field, so we're going to take a quick break and be right back.
Deposit your check here. Or here. Or even there. Deposit your check wherever you are with First Midwest Bank's new mobile deposit. Just tap, snap, deposit. It's that simple. New mobile deposit from First Midwest Bank, serving the communities we call home.
And we're back to action here, coming back from the timeout, almost back to action here. And we're glad you joined us right here on Channel 21 on your New Wave Cable or YHCTV.com, however you may be watching. And this is a broadcast delay from Friday night. Week 6 action, just over the halfway mark of the regular season. So after tonight, there'll be three more regular season games for these teams, and they'll enter to at least one district tournament game. The 10th game of the year is the first round of district play. 18 tournaments for district play, format they've went to for about 3 years now. And here we go, first and 10 for the Bulldogs at the 20-yard line. And Torrey's going to keep it. He's got some space, cuts it up, and he's got more space. He's got room and almost breaks out of the tackle near midfield. But a big gain for the Bulldogs out to about the 46-yard line. Big gain for Torrey and the Bulldogs. Looked like he may have broke free, but got tackled by one of the defensive backs. Nice blocking downfield, all the way down here to about the 40-yard line. Nice block. I think that was Gates out in front, getting him that extra block downfield for the big gain. Four wide receiver personnel and hands off to Alexander. He's up for the first down. Alexander getting the first down, moving the chains for the Bulldogs. And it looks like we're going no huddle offense here for the Bulldogs. And a fake handoff. Torrey's got along the left side and spins. Steps out, and he's across the 35-yard line. Looks like for near a first down. It's going to be close. And another first down for the Bulldogs. Well, Scott City just hasn't found an answer for these quarterback keepers by Torrey. But they've really utilized Lamar Alexander with that handoff up the middle. That's been very successful as well. So that's a tough dynamic there with Torrey with the keepers on the outside and Lamar Alexander up the middle. And a nice 3-yard gain by Alexander along the right tackle. And we're inside 5 minutes to play here in the first half. Four wide receiver set, Alexander in the backfield. And quick handoff, it's a fake handoff and a high pass that just hangs and intercepted and fumbled. Wow, Hunter Gates with the fumble reception, and he's going to go in for the touchdown. Unbelievable. Hunter Gates, touchdown, Bulldogs. Wow. You won't see that often, an interception, and then on the return, a fumble. And Portageville takes it in for the touchdown. Wow. And no flags on the play, so the play will stand. 26-7 score. Wow. Well, everything's going Portageville's way here in the first half, and now Torrey's going to fake the keeper and passes, and it's good for the two-point conversion as Hunter Gates pulls it in, making it a 28-7 score in favor of the Bulldogs. Wow. It is, the fortune is running well for the Bulldogs here tonight. It's homecoming, it might as well, but what a drive. They had a great drive leading up to the interception. Torrey left it hanging a little high and short. That was intended receiver. It was picked off and fumbled away. Nice. I didn't even get to see, even credit whoever got forced the fumble. But picked up by Hunter Gates and run in for the touchdown. What a play. And the two-point conversion good on the pass to Gates. Makes it a 28-7 lead for the Bulldogs. 4:15 remaining here in the first half. And a high short kick and caught around the 20-yard line and returned up the middle and brought down at around the 35-yard line. Bring up first and 10 for the Rams. Sweep to Cox, got a little space, and going to be run out of bounds at around the 44-yard line. That'll be about an 8-yard gain on the play. Actually, they're going to spot him at about the 42-yard line, so a gain of 6 on the play. Bring up 2nd and 4, 4 minutes remaining. Fake sweep, hands it off inside, and it's going to be stopped short of the first down marker. Caden Hillman on the carry, going to be stopped about 2 yards short of the first down. Bring up 3rd and 2 for the Rams. Clock is running, approaching 3.5 minutes remaining in the first half. And big opportunity here for Portageville. If they get this stop on third down, Scott City would be in a position to punt, I would think, here on their own side of the field. Give Portageville another opportunity to score before the half. And want to recognize more of our sponsors, Turf Renovations. If you take a look at the field tonight, it's in great shape, and that's due to Turf Renovations. They do a great job keeping up and providing great field surfaces for not only this field, but many fields in the area, New Madrid, Dexter, Piggott. They've redone Piggott's field this year. It's looking great. And many more throughout the area that I'm probably going to miss. But Turf Renovations does a great job providing great services for these athletes to play on each Friday night. And they do baseball fields as well. And you can check out their projects online, turfrenovations.com. And we thank Turf Renovations bringing you high school football once again this year here on YHC TV. And here we go, back to action. Third and two for the Rams. Big down here with Portageville, a chance to get the ball back here with another chance to score if they can come up with this stop. And a fake sweep, going to be dropping back, looking out to the sideline. It's knocked incomplete. And the receiver was open. The pass was on target, but a nice tackle on that far side. I couldn't quite tell. Knocked that ball loose, making it a fourth down. Coming up for the Rams. We'll see what they elect to do. 3.5 minutes remaining. Heading towards halftime. And it looks like they're going to go for it. Trying to get some momentum here offensively to end the half. Big opportunity here for Portageville to get the stop and the ball right at midfield. And a sweep to Cox. He's coming around. He's going to pick up the first down. Big hit. But he crosses the 45, picks up the first down, moves the chains for the Rams. Lamar Alexander and Brian Pearson in on the tackle. And, oh, nice tackle in the backfield. And the ball is caught for a reception, about a 7-yard gain on the pass. And number two, Eli Berry, 5'7" sophomore with the reception. He's going to bring up a second three, under 3 minutes remaining. So we're going to have to go quick tempo here for the Rams. They've got timeouts, but want to keep the tempo up here towards the end of the half. And a handoff to Cox, and he gets maybe a yard or two. Gets a gain of about a yard and a half. It'll bring up third and a long one, maybe 2 yards. 2:15 remaining. Oh no, he got a fumble on the snap, and it looks like the Bulldogs recover from my vantage point. And that is the case. First down for the Bulldogs. A bad snap. Actually, I don't think it was a bad snap. I think there was a miscommunication on the play call. Wilthong was going back to hand it off. It looks like one of his upbacks, one of the fullbacks, ran into him, knocked the ball loose. And Portageville recovers at the 47-yard line of Scott City. So 1:49 remaining, and Portageville got another chance to score. And... oh, somehow, oh. Is that a fumbarooski? That was a fumbarooski. they ran the fumble Ruski. I don't even know who got the carry. Caught me off guard. Wow. Ian Torrey took the snap, and I thought initially he may have fumbled the snap because he bent down, but I didn't see any scramble for the ball. And one of the linemen, man, I wish I would have caught who picked that ball up, picked it up and ran along the left side for a big gain. They're at the 27-yard line, first and 10. Wow. Ian Torrey, he's got a man along the left side. He's open, and Inky breaks the tackle. And inside the 15-yard line, first down for the Bulldogs. Got plenty of time remaining as well. We got a flag in the backfield. It will be holding against the Bulldogs. So that play will come back. And a nice play there by the Bulldogs, but the holding penalty will bring it back. 10-yard penalty. First and 20 for these Bulldogs at the 37-yard line. Torrey's got plenty of time. He's going deep down the sideline. It's going to be underthrown a bit, and it's going to be wide out of bounds. Second and 20 coming up. Minute and 18, so plenty of time. I don't think time will be an issue on this drive. Just a matter of Portageville can convert the long yardage. And the long yardage here was second and 20. And low snap, Torrey's gonna keep it. And he's got some room, and he's gonna look to get out of bounds, stops the clock, and he comes up with a little hobble. Not sure if he got stepped on or maybe turned an ankle a little bit going out of bounds. Looks like he's going to walk it off. Minute and 12 remaining. Pretty good gain. Gain of about 10 yards, so it'll be third and 10. A good gain there to make it manageable here on these next potential two downs. Minute and 12 remaining. Man in motion. Connor Barham in motion, hands it off to Alexander. He goes along the left side, and I think there's a fumble on the play. I may have been mistaken. Okay, so it's going to be a gain of about 8 yards on that play. It'll bring up fourth and two. Fourth and two coming up with a minute and 3 seconds remaining in the game. We're going to keep it right here as this has been a good one. Portageville has come up with 28 unanswered points. Scott City come out with their first possession, marched down the field in under 3 minutes with a score. Ever since then, it's been Portageville well in hand. And 28 unanswered with a chance to score here. Got a fourth and a long one coming up. So a big down here to extend this drive. Potentially put up a touchdown here before the half. And Portageville did kick off to Scott City on the first possession. So they'll get the ball to open up the second half. So it'd be nice to get a score here and then get the ball right back on the second half kickoff. And Torrey's going to pick up the first down on a sneak and get a pretty good gain out of it. He gets about probably 5 or 6 yards off the quarterback sneak. And a timeout by the Bulldogs, so they pick up the quick first down. Going to call a quick timeout. There's a minute remaining on the clock, so a nice conversion by Torrey. We haven't seen that all night. Might as well. They've been doing a good job. The Portageville offensive line get a good push up front as Lamar Alexander's been just gutting that interior line of the Rams. And Torrey just took it right up the middle for a good gain. And they're going to be well in position to score. They're 15 yards out, first and 10 from the 15-yard line. And good position to score right here before the half. And we'll mention the coaching staff for both teams. Portageville headed up by Jeff Bullock, assisted by Gerald Pickering, Ashley Swims, and Lee Wallace. And on Scott City's side, head coach James Hal May III, assisted by Stephen Hemby, Stephen O'Brien, and Corey Rogers. And here we go. First and 10 for the Bulldogs. A minute remaining. Portageville's got one timeout left. Torrey looking, he's rolling out, he's gonna get brought down. A nice tackle in the backfield by a pair of Rams for Scott City. And it will be another timeout by Portageville, so they're out of timeouts after that one. 50 seconds remaining, it'll be a loss of about 11, 12 yards. That was a big sack in the backfield as Torrey couldn't get away from it. It'll bring up a second and 21 coming up for the Bulldogs. Jeff Bullock having a word with the Bulldogs, trying to come up with a nice drive here, getting pushed back once again. Some long yardage situations, but they've converted. Had a high percentage tonight. And Connor Barham in, and they put Ian Torrey at receiver, and it's going to be thrown short and intercepted. And, yeah, this time they put Ian Torrey at receiver, which he's an outstanding receiver. He's played receiver the last 2 years. And then coming in and playing quarterback, replacing John Garrett Kellums as he graduated last year, and put in Barham, who's the backup quarterback, probably looking for Torrey on that play, deep in the end zone, but ball was just thrown short. And been able to run up under by the Rams for the interception. So it'll be first and 10 at the 12-yard line for the Rams, 39 seconds, so might not see a very aggressive play call here. And a sweep to Cox. And gets about 4 yards on the carry. 30 seconds remaining. I don't see a stoppage in play, so they're probably going to just let the time run out here. Yeah, we're under 10 seconds remaining, so we're just going to let the time run out. That'll bring it into the first half. The Portageville Bulldogs on top of the Scott City Rams, 28-7 after one half of play. A big half for these Bulldogs, 28 unanswered points. And we'll be back with your second half coming up.
Introducing New Wave Wi-Fi at Home.
Now you can stay connected to the web and not the wall. One connection connects multiple computers, so you can surf the internet from any room in your home with no wires, no worries, and no limits to what you can do. Everything is included. One simple call is all it takes. Connect everyone, everywhere, with New Wave Wi-Fi at home.
Wireless modem service now included with every bundle package. Call 1-888-8-NEW-WAVE to...
We at First National Bank proudly announce our new name, FM Bank, First Missouri Bank of SEMO.
When most banks change their name, new ownership is usually the case. This is not true with First National Bank. We have made the positive decision to streamline and update not only our name, but also our look. We have a fresh new logo, signage, lobby graphics, brochures, the works. With the same great service and friendly faces that you have come to expect and deserve, First National Bank is now FM Bank, First Missouri Bank of SEMO.
The area's fastest internet just got faster. Introducing 100 meg internet, now available from New Wave. With 100 meg, there's nothing you can't do. Browse better, stream more, power every device. This is lightning fast internet designed to fit your family's needs. It's brand new and it's the fastest game in town. Get 100 meg internet from New Wave, your local provider of the speed you need. Call 1-888-8-NEW-WAVE today.
Clear!
There's a better way to jumpstart your soil back to health. Apply Enzone to protect and increase nitrogen efficiency without killing bacteria. Apply Prevent to increase phosphorus availability and reduce fixation. Better yet, use them both to get more from your fertilizer investment and see higher potential yields. Ag Explorer, your prescription for healthy soil.
Hi, I'm Shane Horner.
Hi, I'm Tim Ellison.
Hi, my name is Richard Clark.
I'm Lori Amos.
I'm Rob Blackwell.
And I'm Ryan Bassetti.
Hi, I'm Alan King.
Hello, I'm Larry Ellison, and we're proud to be part of the Harry Blackwell Ford family here in Malden, Missouri.
Deposit your check here. Or here. Or even there. Deposit your check wherever you are with First Midwest Bank's new mobile deposit. Just tap, snap, deposit. It's that simple. New mobile deposit from First Midwest Bank, serving the communities we call home.
And welcome. We're here at halftime getting ready for the third quarter. The Portageville Bulldogs had a great first half. 28-7 lead for the Bulldogs. They got out and really responded well after an opening score by the Scott City Rams. Scott City opened up with a quick touchdown just 3 minutes into the game, and since then it's been all Portageville. 28 unanswered points for the Bulldogs and a couple miscues by Scott City, turning into points for the Bulldogs, notably an interception deep in their own territory, fumbled away as Hunter Gates took it into the end zone. So that was a turnover and a score right there on one play, a turnover that they forced and then turned right back over, and Portageville turned it in for a touchdown. And a couple of miscues, not picking up some fourth downs in their own territory. Portageville had some short fields that they converted on. So we got a game here. Scott City's in this game. We'll see how this plays out in the second half. But Portageville's played well, probably as well as they've played all year. And we're set to go here in the third quarter as Portageville will get the kickoff. And they kick it off short, looking off for that onside kick. And it will be recovered right at the 50-yard line for the Bulldogs. So great field position for Portageville to get started here.
Bulldogs
Here we go. Torrey under center this time. He's going to hand off to Alexander, and he bolts through the hole and looked like he got taken down, but skirts out of it. And he's going to pick up the first down, getting out to the 40-yard line. First and 10. Alexander's just been great up the middle. Yes, that's a great job up front by that Bulldog offensive line, getting good push and some good yardage for Alexander up the middle. And Torrey's going to keep it. He bounces out, nowhere to go. He's going to try to circle back, and he's going to be down. And yeah, the flag's going to come out for intentional grounding as he was going to the ground. Didn't see there was a guy he threw to, but it may not have made the line of scrimmage, but I don't think it matters if he's throwing to the receiver that's behind the line of scrimmage. I think that was Ryan Priggle out there that was behind the line of scrimmage, but looks like it won't matter as they will enforce the intentional grounding penalty. It's a loss of down plus a 10-yard penalty. Or maybe it's a 5-yard penalty. Not sure, but it's going to be second and 15 coming up for the Bulldogs. Or first and 15. It should be second and 15. That's a loss of down, but I don't know. And pass across the middle, incomplete. And a timeout by the Bulldogs. Coach Bullock not liking what he's seeing here early on, getting started with this second half. So we're going to take a quick break and be right back.
We at First National Bank proudly announce our new name, FM Bank, First Missouri Bank of SEMO.
When most banks change their name, new ownership is usually the case. This is not true with First National Bank. We have made the positive decision to streamline and update not only our name, but also our look. We have a fresh new logo, signage, lobby graphics, brochures, the works, with the same great service and friendly faces that you have come to expect and deserve. First National Bank is now FM Bank, First Missouri Bank of SEMO.
And we're back to action here. It's going to be second and 15 for the Bulldogs. Torrey with the snap. He got some time looking downfield. That's Ryan Priggle with the reception, and he's going to be out close to a first down. Nice play there by the Bulldogs. Ryan Priggle wide open, coming across the field. Nice pass by Torrey and reception to Priggle, and it's going to be a first down. Moves the chains on a big play there. It was second 15. They picked it up. First and 10 for the Bulldogs. And a handoff to Alexander up the middle. He's got some good yardage. He shakes off the tackle, and he's going for the end zone. Touchdown, Bulldogs. And a great run by Alexander. Breaks the tackle, takes it in for the touchdown. He's had a great night rushing the ball here tonight. Great blocking up front. Got around the edge and scooted for the touchdown, making it 34-7 in favor of the Portageville Bulldogs. And we got just over 11 minutes remaining here in the third quarter. So a quick strike, 45 seconds into this game, and they're on the board. And a low kick, it's going to be no good. The score remains at 34-7 in favor of the Portageville Bulldogs. And we appreciate our sponsors, A-Plus Family Clinic in Portageville, along 203 East 3rd Street. Family nurse practitioner Lorna Turnage and staff there to provide your medical solutions. Call for your next appointment, 573-379-2100. That's A-Plus Family Clinic along East 3rd Street in Portageville, helping bring you high school football right here on YHC TV, Channel 21, on your New Wave Communications cable. And Portageville has just been firing on all cylinders tonight. Sure, they've made some mistakes, some turnovers that they'd like to have back, but they've really responded well here tonight ever since that first touchdown drive by the Rams. Anytime a team just marches down the field on the first possession within 3 minutes, pretty impressive. You kind of think that's maybe how we'll see the game tonight, but it's been totally opposite ever since that drive. Portageville scoring 34 unanswered points and totally shutting down this Scott City Ram offense. And Portageville looking good to start this second half. And a kick down the far side is going to stay in bounds. Picked up, and great coverage by the Bulldogs. Well, he gets around the sideline. Looked like they were going to have him deep in their own territory, but a nice return. Pushed out past the 30-yard line. And here we go, first and 10 for Scott City. And a sweep to the outside. Great defense by the Bulldogs in the backfield. Two of them there, one of them a little shaken up. Dakota Ivy in on that stop. And he's going to come off the field. He took a good shot, but delivered one himself as well. Second long for the Rams, second 12. And drop back in the pass. He's looking along the near side and caught. Tackle, nice tackle there by Travius Johnson. That'll bring up a third and about four coming up. Gain of eight on the play, third and four coming up. Throwing it out, and going to be a first down. A nice throw along the sideline, as that was Eli Berry with the reception along the sideline. Picks up the first down. And it's going to be a jump off sides by Portageville. Like Jay Mabia trying to get a jump on the snap, but going to pick up the penalty, make it a first and five for the Rams. First and five for the Rams. And nice handoff. Looks like it's going to be close to a first down. And Braden Cox converts the first down on the run. Moves the chains for the Rams. So Braden Cox getting a heavy load tonight, as he does each week for these Rams. And an out and up route deep along the sideline and incomplete. Looked like a pretty well-executed play, but couldn't quite bring it down on the far side. That'll bring up second and 10 for Scott City. Portageville fans getting behind this defense, and a handoff to Cox. He gets at about the 40-yard line, gain of about five on the play, it looks like. Gain of four. That'll bring up a third and six. Looking to pass, and it looks like it's caught along the sideline. Oh, incomplete. Looked like it was completed on that far side, but it'll bring up fourth and six for Scott City. 7:54 remaining in this third quarter. Fourth down, being aggressive here, rolling out, looking short to Cox, and nice upended tackle in the open field by Ian Torrey. Actually, that was number 24, Sam Elders, and that will move the chains. It was right at the first down marker, and it'll be first and 10 for Scott City. And a sweep to Cox. He's getting wrapped up behind the line of scrimmage. Nice pursuit by the Portageville defense. And Chris Garman on the tackle. Nice pursuit by this Portageville defense. Really getting after it behind the line of scrimmage. And we have a flag. That'll be a personal foul on the Scott City. And I'm assuming it was after the play. So it'll be second down and long if that is the case. Yep, that is the case. It was after the play. So a 15-yard penalty after a play that got little to no gain. I think actually a slight loss. So that was about a 16-yard loss on the play once you include the penalty. Brings up a second and 25 for Scott City. Here we go. And carry and a pretty good yardage as he was hitting the backfield. Cox gets out for about a 4-yard gain. And a blitz up the middle, great pursuit, and it goes down quick. Looks like we had a safety in on that. Yeah, Brian Pearson in on that tackle. And it'll be turnover on downs. It was a fourth and long play, and a great play call. Just bring the heat, put the pressure on them, bring about six defenders. Can't really block them up front once you bring that many, and they're going to be on a pass play. And great defense. Turnover on downs. First and 10 for the Bulldogs. In total control of this game, they've really set the tone coming out in the second half, scoring and then coming up with a big stop here. Now getting the ball at midfield. Torrey, there's a flag on the play. It's going to be a holding call, looks like, in the backfield. Around the line of scrimmage. And we'll be holding on the Bulldogs. And the holding penalty on the Bulldogs is declined. Scott City had a pretty good defensive down there. They had a 4-yard loss taking down Torrey, so they'll take the yardage. Second 14 now. And a quick handoff up the middle. Lamar Alexander getting the first down. Tough yardage out on the back end of that carry. And he picks up the first down at right at the 40-yard line. Big carry for Lamar Alexander. He's been tough all night, hitting the hole hard. And as I've said, giving credit to that offensive line, getting that push up front, getting the hole for Alexander, and he's been hitting it hard all night. Four wide receivers set. Quick snap, and it's on the ground. And thinking the Bulldogs fell on it. And Bulldogs do recover. Might get a short gain out of it, actually. Maybe half a yard, so it'll be pretty much second and 10 coming up for these Bulldogs. And Torrey's on a keeper, and they brought a blitz. Probably expecting Torrey to have a keeper on that down. And they stuff him around the line of scrimmage, maybe a short gain. Bring up third and 9 for the Bulldogs, under 5 minutes to play here in the third quarter. And jump offsides by the Rams. It's surely an offside penalty. Didn't see any movement by the Bulldogs, and that is the case. Offsides penalty. And that'll bring up a third and 4. Yeah, about third and 4 for the Bulldogs. Makes it a little bit more manageable here, so see what the Bulldogs can come up with. I'm sure we're in 4-down territory here. 34-7 lead and into Scott City territory. Surely 4-down territory. Torrey rolling out, steps up, and he's going deep, and he's got a receiver. He's got him, and oh, just out of the fingertips of Hunter Gates. That was a great pass by Torrey. Hunter Gates did a great job getting under that ball. You can see he had to make a little correction in his route. He did a good job getting under it. And maybe just got his feet out from under him, unable to bring that in. But a great pass, a great route, and a great correction by Gates. Just unable to bring it in, but a great play nonetheless. Fourth and five coming up here. Fourth and four, really. Fourth and four. And blitz coming off the left side. Torrey's going to be hit in the backfield. It's incomplete, so it'll be a turnover on downs. As Scott City will take over. Great play call by Scott City, bringing that blitz off the left side, forcing Torrey to roll out and didn't really have anywhere to go. He threw it about 5 yards behind the line of the scrimmage, so really no chance on that play for the Bulldogs. Great play call by Scott City, getting the ball back. First and 10 on their own 35-yard line. Just over 4 minutes remaining here in the third quarter. We have a flag on the play. And it's against the Bulldogs. I looked down for a second, didn't see the signal for the penalty. Apologize for that. May have been a personal foul penalty, as much yardage as this is, and it is. It's got to be a personal foul penalty. Went from the 35 to midfield at the 50-yard line, so it was a personal foul penalty on the Bulldogs. And we got a timeout on the field, so we'll go to our sponsors. Want to give a shout-out to Delta Auto Parts and Salvage here in Portageville along Highway 61 North, specializing in domestic car and light truck parts. That's Delta Auto Parts and Salvage. That's Colin Daugherty and his staff. And serve your needs for any auto parts you may need or salvage. Go to deltaautoparts.com for parts information. We appreciate Delta Auto Parts and Salvage off of Highway 61 here in Portageville, helping bring, once again, high school football to YHC-TV. And here we go. We got first and 10 for the Rams. They force the turnover on downs. And miscommunication on that handoff, looked like. And that'll be a loss of a couple yards as Wilthong goes to the ground. So that's happened a couple times here for Scott City tonight. Unable to execute that handoff. Maybe some miscommunication on the actual play call. So that'll bring up second and 11 for the Rams. And some movement up front on both sides. We'll see if one induced the other. And it will be false start on the Rams. So that'll back him up another 5 yards. So it'll be second and 16 coming up for Scott City. Looked short and out of the fingertips of number 20, Jaden Kaiser. Looked like it would have been a short gain if it was caught. Had a couple of Bulldogs surrounding him, so it'll bring up third and long, third and 16, coming up for these Rams. pass. Wilfong looking across the middle, and looks like it bounced. Looking for Kaiser, and that's the signal. Incomplete pass, bringing up 4th and 16 for Scott City. Just under 3 minutes remaining here in the third quarter. And we'll recognize the cheerleaders for the Portageville Bulldogs this year. Brianna Jones, senior, also junior, Brenna Corbett. Junior, Shelby Roan. Sophomore, Lily Beth Babb. Sophomore, Maisie Hall. Sophomore, Callie Roberts. Freshman, Destiny Adams. Freshman, Elizabeth Compere. Freshman, Maggie Frakes. Freshman, Reed Grady. Freshman, Anna Hayes. And freshman, Kelsey Jones. And on fourth down, Scott City Rams go for it, and they are stuffed in the backfield. Fumbled and stopped in the backfield, and it'll be 1st and 10 for the Bulldogs at around the 40-yard line. 1st and 10, Portageville. All the momentum on Portageville's side, got a big lead, great field position here. Pretty much all they need to do is just move the ball up the field, keep the clock running, and just move towards the end zone, and this victory will be in hand if they can just execute this offense without turning it over here. And a quick handoff up the middle. Alexander powering out for about a 7 to 8 yard gain. Second and 3, gain of 7 on the play by Alexander. And another handoff. Alexander hits the hole. He's going to pick up the first down. First and 10 for the Bulldogs. And movement up front. Looks like Scott City may have jumped off sides. I didn't see any movement on Portageville's side, but. And it is off sides on Scott City. So Scott City's jumped off sides a number of times tonight, helping this Portageville offense coming with some shorter yardage. So here we go. It's 1st and 5 at the 24-yard line for the Bulldogs. And handoff up the middle. Alexander out for... he's still chucking along. He's got about a 4 to 5 yard gain. He's going to be close to a first down. It looks like we've got a timeout for measurement. Got a pretty close call here. And just a few inches short. Be 3rd down and inches, looks like, for the Bulldogs. Come And a handoff to Alexander, and he picks up the first down easy. First and 10. Now they're inside the 20-yard line. From the 18, first and 10 for Portageville. Got another handoff. Well, a keeper, actually, a fake handoff. Alexander gets out in front, blocks for Torrey. Looks like a 4 to 5 yard gain. Looks like a gain of 4. Second and 6 here for the Bulldogs. 1 minute remaining in the third quarter. And a quick handoff to Alexander, and he's got a couple. And under 30 seconds now, third and 4, Portageville. Oh, it's a lot of movement up front. And false start this time on the offense. So that'll back him up 5 yards. It'll make it about a 3rd and 9. Pressure coming from the left side. Torrey's stepping up. He's going to break out. We've got a holding in the backfield. It's going to be close to a touchdown, and it is a touchdown, but it will come back. And holding on the offense. So that'll back it up 10 yards. And just 1 second remaining in the third quarter. And that'll do it, as that brings it into the third quarter. The Portageville Bulldogs on top, 34-7. And we'll be back with your fourth and final quarter coming up.
The area's fastest internet just got faster. Introducing 100 meg internet, now available from New Wave. With 100 meg, there's nothing you can't do. Browse better, stream more, power every device. This is lightning fast internet designed to fit your family's needs. It's brand new, and it's the fastest game in town. Get 100 meg internet from New Wave, your local provider of the speed you need. Call 1-888-8-NEW-WAVE today.
Clear!
There's a better way to jumpstart your soil back to health. Apply Enzone to protect and increase nitrogen efficiency without killing bacteria. Apply Prevent to increase phosphorus availability and reduce fixation. Better yet, use them both to get more from your fertilizer investment and see higher potential yields. Ag Explorer, your prescription for healthy soil.
And we're back here at Vic Reeves Athletic Field in Portageville. well in control of this game. We've got one quarter to go, but it's been all Portageville ever since the first possession of this game. Scott City took the ball for a long drive and scored within 3 minutes to make it 7-0. And ever since then, it's been all Portageville. 34 unanswered points. And Scott City just hasn't been able to put anything together ever since. Portageville with the ball. They did have a false start penalty and a holding penalty, so backs it up, making it a first and 19 here. And a pass over the middle and picked off. Turned over to the Rams. So looking on the bright side, it was first down, but just call it a long punt on first down because at least it was deep down the field and backs up Scott City at their 12-yard line. Handoff, Braden Cox going to be swarmed around the line of scrimmage, maybe a short gain. And that's the strength of this Scott City offense is heading off to Cox. He's broken out a few runs, but outside of that long run in the first quarter and maybe a 15-yard run there in the second quarter, it really hasn't been much. There for Braden Cox in the running game. So we're down 34-7. You'd think they'd be looking to pass more, but we'll see what Scott City comes up with here. Will Fong under center. He's going to look and throw the long pass. He's open down the sideline, completed, and pushed out of bounds. Nice completion there from Will Fong. Couldn't see who the reception was there on the far side. But a nice play call. Got the open receiver down the field. Will Fong put it right in stride where he can get those yards after catch. Out to the 49-yard line in Portageville territory. 11 minutes remaining. Off, stuffed at the line of scrimmage. Yeah, Braden Cox. Well, he's got to be 30 yards. He's got to have 30 carries in this game. I mean, he's carried the load tonight and had a few big gains, but Portageville's done a great job limiting him, not letting him get out of the backfield for big gains. So credit to the Portageville defense and their effort on him tonight. Second and 10 coming up. Defense! 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 Wilfong rolling out. He's got a short receiver and through the hands. And that ball intended for Sam Elders. Couldn't bring it in. Nice play otherwise. Rolled out. Got that short reception where he could turn it upfield. And unable to catch it, bringing up third and 10. And another rollout off the fake handoff. And nowhere to go, so just throws it over the head of his closer receiver. But no real chance to bring that in. Bringing up fourth and 10 for Scott City. And big down here for Scott City. Keep this drive alive. And pressure up the middle, and a nice pass out to the flat. Oh, nice broken tackle, and he's going to – whoa, he breaks another tackle. Racing down the sideline and inside the 20-yard line. And a nice play that would look like it may have been short of the sticks. Broke that tackle, broke another tackle as he got upfield and took it for a big gain. Inside the 20-yard line with 10 minutes remaining here in the game. And we're at the 16-yard line for the Rams, first and 10. See if they can get their first score since the opening drive of the game in the first quarter. Wilthong looking across the middle, and it's tipped up, almost intercepted. Bring up second and 10. Yo, Wilthong looking and almost intercepted. That was Ryan Priggle, and on the defense, broke it up. I take that back. That's Connor Barham on the defense there, defensive back. Nice breakup by Connor Barham, bringing up a third and 10 for the Rams. Dump off pass, and not much there. And that pass only went for, actually, a loss of a yard on that short reception. Fourth and 11. Scott City needs this to keep their drive alive, have any sort of outside chance of. Making this close, here we go. And being chased from behind, he gets rid of it, and it's intercepted. Hunter Gates with the interception, trying to make a play here. And he's gonna be brought down. And we got a flag out around the 40-yard line. We'll see what the flag is. I'm sure it'll be some sort of personal foul penalty. And that is the case. Personal foul penalty on it was signal against Scott City. And it's a dead ball foul, so it's after the interception, so it will be first and 10, Bulldogs. And it is against Portageville. Okay, at first it was signaled to Scott City, then they made the correction. Against Portageville, so it'll just back up the Portageville Bulldogs from where they took the ball out, which Hunter Gates had the great interception, returned it out to about the 15 or so yard line, so it'll be half the distance of the goal from that point, so ends up being about a 6-7 yard penalty. Actually about a 10-yard penalty. It was out to the 20-yard line. Half the distance of the goal from the 20 is the 10 where they're at. So effectively a 10-yard penalty. Looks like referee having discussion with a couple of the players that are probably getting after each other here tonight. 8:41 remaining in the game. First and 10. And Torrey's got a keeper. He's got the sideline to see if he can turn it on. Couldn't quite get past those backs, but a big gain out past the 30-yard line, or close to the 30-yard line. Big gain for the Bulldogs. First and 10 for the Bulldogs. 34-7 lead, well in hand. Just looking to move the ball up the field. And a quick pitch to Alexander. He's got some space going to the outside. Cuts it up and gets a nice gain of about 7 yards. And make it more like 8 to 9 yards. Bring up a second and one. And Torrey's going to keep it along the left side. He's chased from behind. He's cutting it back. Oh, he's getting into trouble now. Now he cuts it back again. And he's going to get some yardage out of him, pick up the first down. And he's got a big gain. Look at him get across the sideline and into Rams territory out around the 40-yard line. Wow. Torrey, a great athlete. Switched directions about 3 to 4 times. Breaks down the sideline for a big gain. Well, it looked like he was in trouble. Once you roll out, then you change directions, it could be big trouble, but he's the best athlete on the field, and it shows. So he got down the sideline for a big gain into Scott City territory with 7.5 minutes remaining in this game. Well in control for the Bulldogs. And a fake handoff, and a throw. It's going to be caught. What a catch. Hunter Gates on the reception. This guy is making plays all over the field, offensively, defensively. Had to stretch out for that one. And he come down with it. Pretty good placement there by Torrey as he was rolling out. Threw it up, and Gates comes down with it. Seven minutes remaining. Clock's running. And handoff. Alexander hitting the hole hard, and he's going to be inside the 5-yard line, close to the goal line. Second down and 4 from the 4-yard line. There's the first down markers just short of the end zone. Torrey's going to keep it right up the middle. Looks like he's going to trot in for the touchdown. And that makes it a 40-7 score in favor of the Bulldogs. Great drive finished off by Torrey with the keeper. And they're going to line up to go for 2 here. Haven't really fared well on the... And a direct snap.
3-point conversion is good.
Didn't quite see who got on that carry, but it's going to be good. The 2-point conversion is good, bringing it to 42-7 in favor of the Bulldogs. Haven't fared well on that extra point attempt tonight, so 2-point conversions worked well for them tonight, bringing up the score to 42-7 And we recognize some more of our sponsors. Butler Drugstore here in Portageville, 222 East Main Street. A full-service pharmacy also offering a nice selection of gifts and jewelry. Keep them in mind for your all your medication needs. 222 East Main Street. Call 573-379-5469. That's Dr. Trey Rowan and staff providing your prescription solutions here in Portageville. Also, we have Greenpoint Ag in Portageville offering seed, fertilizer, crop protection products, and custom application services. You can visit them online, greenpointag.com, or call 379-3816. Keep them in mind for your spring crop, for all your fertilizer and crop services. That's Greenpoint Ag in Portageville. Here we go, kickoff. And got out to about the close to the 30-yard line. And the clock will run. Now it's a 35-point advantage. Well, it stops now, but it will run from here on out, 35-point mercy rule. And we got a timeout on the field. So we will be right back.
Hi, I'm Shane Horner.
Hi, I'm Tim Ellison.
Hi, my name is Richard Clark.
I'm Lori Amos.
I'm Rob Blackwell.
And I'm Ryan Bassetti.
Hi, I'm Alan King.
Hello, I'm Larry Ellison, and we're proud to be part of the Harry Blackwell Ford family here in Malden, Missouri.
Deposit your check here. Or here. Or even there. Deposit your check wherever you are with First Midwest Bank's new mobile deposit. Just tap, snap, deposit. It's that simple. New mobile deposit from First Midwest Bank, serving the communities we call home.
And we're back at Vic Reeves Athletic Field in Portageville. Portageville just scored, converted a two-point conversion to go up 42-7. The clock is running due to the 35-point advantage for the Bulldogs. First and 10 for the Rams. And gain of two or three on the carry. Braden Cox, I'll tell you, he's carried the ball tonight. I think he's had every carry of theirs, maybe other than a handful. I mean, he has had the workload tonight. 5.5 minutes remaining. The clock will run. And a handoff, short gain, 5 minutes to play.
Handoff goes 33 times. Tackle made by number 55, Bryce Loman.
And we got a fumble on the play, and Scott City recovers. Bring up a got a player down for Portageville. Thank you.
up on his feet. Let's give this young man a big round of applause.
It looks like that was Chris Garman.
Rams have been facing fourth down and two.
Got injured on the play. He's walking off the field. Hopefully he's going to be all right. And we got 4:13 remaining in the game. Clock is running. We'll continue to run. And that's a fourth down carry on fourth and two, and it's going to be close. Yeah, we got a timeout, official's timeout for measurement. Scott City will be short of the needed yardage on fourth down, so it'll be a turnover on downs. The Portageville Bulldogs will take over first and 10 with 3:43 remaining in the game. So pretty much going to just take the air out of the ball here, run out the clock, and count down to Portageville's third victory of the season. They come into this game 2-3, have a very tough schedule here early on, playing the likes of Crothersville, Malden. You know, those two teams were the toughest by far. And getting a nice win here tonight against these Scott City Rams. And we've got a timeout on the field, and we'll be right back.
Introducing New Wave Wi-Fi at home. Now you can stay connected to the web and not the wall. One connection connects multiple computers, so you can surf the internet from any room in your home with no wires, no worries, and no limits to what you can do. Everything is included. One simple call is all it takes. Connect everyone, everywhere, with New Wave Wi-Fi at home.
Wireless modem service now included with every bundle package. Call 1-888-8NEW.
And we're back here at Vic Reeves Athletic Field getting set to wrap this one up here from Portageville. Portageville's got the ball, first and 10. And we're going to close this one out here in week six to even their record at 500 to go 3-3 on the year as they will take on East Prairie next week. So it'll probably be an even matchup going over there to East Prairie next week. Should be a good one. And a quick pitch to Alexander, and he's going to turn on the burners into the end zone. And nice run, Lamar Alexander, putting on the exclamation point for the Bulldogs, making it 48-7 in favor of the Bulldogs. He's had a great night. We're not keeping up the stats tonight, but he's well over 100 yards rushing, and he's had a big defensive night as well. Great effort by Lamar Alexander tonight for the Bulldogs. Snap, holds down, looks good. And it is, making it 49-7. And the clock continues to run, even though there's out of play. It's well in hand here for the Bulldogs. So we've got 2.5 minutes remaining. And now the clock will stop. Short kick returned out to about the 43, 44-yard line, and we got flags on the field. Looks like a personal foul to be assessed to the Rams. A little too much contact after the whistle looked like. And that is the case. Clock's going to be running. It seems like it'll take forever for this game to be over. 49-7. And Cox with the carry, it looks like, and he just won't go down. One of his biggest gains of the night gets out to about an 8-yard gain, or the biggest gain of the second half. He's just been covered up ever since the first quarter. Unable to get any yardage, really, since that first drive, and bring up a second and 2 with a minute and a half remaining in the game. Snap and good defense by the Bulldogs. Going to stop him short of the first down. Cox gets maybe a gain of 1. Third and 1. We got 45 seconds remaining in the game. Just a few plays left here. And we got a timeout on the field. And just a little brief stoppage in the play, and the play will resume. This will likely be the last play of the game. We're down to 30 seconds left. Play clock's at about 15, so we'll see the play get off, and that'll pretty much do it. And run to the outside. Cox picks up the first down. Tackle made by number 32 on a grand on number 36. And that's the end of the game. 49-7 victory for the Portageville Bulldogs. Great effort by these Portageville Bulldogs here tonight. Best game they've played all year. They really showed up to play. As I've said all game, Scott City had a good drive. The opening kickoff drove it down, scored within 3 minutes. And from that point on, it was all Portageville's. They pick up the victory 49-7 dominant here tonight. They moved to 3-3 on the year. Move on to play East Prairie on the road next week. Scott City undefeated coming in here tonight. 5-0. They fall to 5-1 going forward. But we'll see if Portageville can put a little run together here midway of the season here for the second half. This is by far the best game they've played with, considering the competition. Big win last week against Kelly. Nice victory here tonight. A win next week against East Prairie would really look good for these Portageville Bulldogs going into district play here in just a matter of 3 weeks in the football season. And that will do it for us here tonight from Vic Reeves Athletic Field. Hopefully you'll join us for another one down the road. Good night, everyone.